Welcome, Storytime Buddies! I'm so glad you could join us! Sweet Pea has picked out more of his favorite books to read. Do you like story time?
Yeah!
All right! Pete loves to dance. Check out his groovy dance moves as we read Pete the Cat and the Cool Cat Boogie by Kimberly and James Dean. Pete the Cat was learning a new dance, the Cool Cat Boogie. Then Grumpy Toad came along.
I really dig that song, but Pete, you dance all wrong.
Pete did not know what to say. He just turned and walked away. Pete couldn't sleep at all that night.
What if Grumpy Toad was right? What if my moves are bad?
The thought of not dancing made Pete feel sad.
Dancing is like magic! When I hear a groovy beat, I'm full of happy in my feet! I won't give up! I love to dance! Let me give it one more chance!
Pete was practicing the Cool Cat Boogie when he saw Squirrel.
Hey Squirrel! How do you dance? How do you groove? Can you teach me how to move?
Sure, Pete! It's a simple song! Just cha-cha-cha and dance along! Ah! Ouch, Pete! You stepped on my toes! That's not how this dance goes!
Pete did not know what to say. He just turned and walked away.
But dancing is like magic. When I hear a groovy beat, I'm full of happy in my feet. I won't give up. I love to dance. Let me give it one more chance.
Pete was still practicing the Cool Cat Boogie when Gus came along.
Hey Gus, how do you dance? How do you groove? Can you teach me how to move?
Sure, Pete. It's a simple song. Just do the robot and dance along.
Ouch! Pete, you bopped me on the nose. That is not how this dance goes.
Pete did not know what to say. He just turned and walked away.
But dancing is like magic. When I hear a groovy beat, I'm full of happy in my feet. I won't give up. I love to dance. Let me give it one more chance.
Pete was still trying to do the Cool Cat Boogie when Turtle came along.
Hey, Turtle. How do you dance? How do you groove? Can you teach me how to move?
Sure, Pete. It's a simple song. Just shake your tail and dance along. Oh no! Pete, you fell! You tripped over my shell. Everybody knows that's not how this dance goes.
Pete felt like giving up. Wise Old Owl had been watching from his tree.
Pete, it doesn't matter how you move, as long as you are being you.
You're right! I never want to miss a chance to dance! When you hear a groovy beat and you feel happy in your feet, just dance, 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 dance!
Awesome! Pete learns the value of being himself when he dances. Do you like to boogie?
I do!
Me too!
So do I!
Let's march into the second story. Pete the Cat, The Petes Go Marching by James Dean. Ready, set, let's go!
The Petes go marching one by one, hurrah, hurrah! The Petes go marching one by one. To town to get out of the rain. five, hurrah, hurrah. The Peets go marching five by five, hurrah, hurrah. The Peets go marching five by five, the groovy ones love to take a drive, and they all go marching down to town to get out of the rain. The Peets go marching six by six, hurrah, hurrah. The Peets go marching six by six, hurrah, hurrah. The Peets go marching six by six, the groovy ones love to pick up sticks, and they all go marching down to town to get out.
To the beat of his own drum and met some cool friends along the way. Moving on, Pete learns about the value of teamwork while working on a project for the science fair. Let's find out how as we read Pete the Cat and the Supercool Science Fair by Kimberly and James Dean. Pete cannot wait for Friday. His school is having a science fair. Pete has never been a scientist. Now he can try it out. Pete's teacher tells the students they will do experiments in groups. Pete is in a group with Callie, Gus, and Squirrel. Our experiment is going to be groovy, says Pete. What should we do?
Let's build a mini submarine, says Callie.
Or grow a giant tree,
says Squirrel.
Or invent an invisible guitar, says Pete.
Why don't we make a volcano?
Asks Gus.
Wow!
They all say.
Volcanoes are awesome!
The group plans the experiment at Pete's house. His mom brings them snacks. Would any scientist like a cookie? She asks. They all raise their hands. The cookies are warm and gooey. The scientists check the big book of experiments for materials. They need glue, water, newspaper, paint, and a plastic bottle for the volcano. They need vinegar, baking soda, liquid dish soap, and a secret ingredient for the lava. Pete and Gus mix the glue and water. Squirrel and Callie tear the newspaper into strips. They cover the plastic bottle with glue and paper. It looks like a sticky, white volcano.
Oh no!
The paint in the brown bottle is blue.
What are we going to do?
Asks Callie. They can't find brown paint anywhere.
That's pretty cool, says Pete. Maybe it's okay that we have a blue volcano.
We'll be the only group with a blue volcano,
says Squirrel.
Let's test the lava so we know the volcano will erupt at the science fair, Pete says.
Gus pours baking soda and liquid dish soap into the volcano, and Callie adds vinegar. nothing happens. At first. All of a sudden, a lot of lava starts coming out.
Super cool!
Says Callie. The team high-five each other. But the lava is still coming out. Soon, it is a huge mess.
Oh, Mom isn't going to be happy,
says Pete. At least the scientists are ready for the fair on Friday. When Pete and his team arrive at the fair, they see all the other groovy experiments. They all look awesome. Grumpy Toad and Octopus grew rock candy in jars. Emma and Marty made slime.
We don't stand a chance,
says Gus.
Don't worry, we have the secret ingredient, says Pete.
At the science fair, Pete's teacher loves the blue volcano.
Wait till you see it erupt,
Pete says. The whole class watches Callie pour vinegar into the volcano. A second later, glitter lava gushes out. Everyone cheers. The scientists cheer the loudest.
Science experiments are hard work,
says Pete, but being on an awesome team makes them a whole lot easier. Great teamwork, huh?
Yeah! Totally!
They worked hard and made an awesome volcano. In the next story, Pete is hanging out with five little ducks. Let's find out what they do in Pete the Cat, Five Little Ducks by James Dean.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Five little ducks went out to play with one cool cat leading the way. Pete the Cat said, let's splash and swim, but only four little ducks jumped in.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Four little ducks went out to play with one cool cat leading the way. Pete the Cat said, let's jump and hop, but only three little ducks popped up.
1, 2, 3.
Three little ducks went out to play with one cool cat leading the way. Pete the Cat said, let's try the swings, but only two little ducks flapped their wings.
1, 2.
Two little ducks went out to play with one cool the cat said, let's run inside, but only one little duck came by.
1.
One little duck was there to play with one cool cat this rainy day. Pete the cat said, it's me and you, but that little duck left too.
That Pete the Cat went out to play, but all of the ducks had gone away. Pete the Cat said,
hey, what was that?
And the five little ducks came running back. Five little ducks all yelled,
hooray!
They made Pete a treat that day. Pete the Cat said, let's all have
Just when Pete thought his friends had left him, they all came back. What an awesome surprise! In the next story, Pete becomes a firefighter and saves a friend. We'll find out who as we read Pete the Cat, Firefighter Pete by James Dean. We are going on a class trip today, says Principal Nancy.
She leads the class to a bright yellow bus.
Everyone climbs on board.
I wonder where we're going, says Pete.
They are going to visit the firehouse today. The bus parks next to the bright red firehouse. Pete and his classmates are excited.
The firehouse is huge!
It's so big it can hold two long red fire trucks and all of the firefighters' equipment.
Ring!
The firefighters show the kids around. They give everyone a turn to ring the old brass fire bell outside the firehouse. Then all the kids take turns sliding down the firefighter's pole.
Whee!
Callie yells as she glides down. The firefighters allow the kids to try on their gear. Firefighters wear a lot of equipment. First, Pete puts on the heavy black overalls. Then, he steps into the tall black boots. A firefighter helps Pete put on the heavy yellow jacket. Finally, they place a hard black helmet on Pete's head. All this gear is very heavy. Pete can barely move. The firefighters allow the kids to explore one of the fire trucks. Callie sits in the driver's seat. She presses the horn.
Brrr!
It's so loud that all the kids cover their ears. Then Pete turns on the sirens and lights. The sirens blare.
Woo-wee, woo-wee!
The lights flash red and yellow. Suddenly, a loud bell rings in the firehouse. Uh-oh, it's the fire alarm. There's a fire in town.
Gear up, Pete!
The firefighters scramble into their gear very quickly. Pete puts on his gear, too. They all climb aboard the fire truck and turn on the siren and lights. Firefighter Pete and the firefighters are on their way.
Woo-wee, woo-wee!
The fire engine races through town and the lights flash round and round. A firefighter presses the horn. All the other cars move out of the way. There's the fire! It's hot and loud, but the firefighters know exactly what to do. They work together as a team to connect the fire truck to the fire hydrant. Then the firefighters also attach a long, heavy hose to the truck. Firefighter Pete gives the signal and the firefighters turn on the water. Whoosh! The water gushes out very fast. Several firefighters must hold the hose to control it. Pete helps direct the hose as they spray the fire with water. The fire is starting to go out. There is smoke everywhere. Suddenly, Pete hears yelling from the roof.
Oh no! It's Grumpy Toad! He needs to be rescued!
The firefighters raise a long ladder from the truck. Crank, crank, crank. The ladder goes up and up and up. Firefighter Pete and another firefighter help Grumpy Toad climb down the ladder carefully.
Yay! The fire is out and everyone is safe!
The firefighters drive back to the firehouse. They take off all their gear. They pat Pete on the back and say,
Good job, Pete!
Firefighter Pete helped save the day! What an excellent story! Pete's bravery helped him save Grumpy Toad from danger.
Wow! It's Pete's first day of school. Let's see how it goes as we read Pete the Kid's First Day of Preschool by Kimberly and James Dean. Today is a big day for Pete the Kitty. It's going to be so cool! It's his first day of preschool!
What should Pete bring to school today? He takes pencils, glue sticks, a paintbrush, and crayons too. Of course, Pete's favorite color is blue. he runs to put everything in his new backpack. Pete's backpack is really groovy. He picked it out himself at the store. Now it is time to head out the door. Don't forget your snack, Pete, says Mom. Pete thinks a banana will be an awesome snack. The school bus stops in front of Pete's house. Pete gets on the bus for the first time. He knows just what to do. His big brother, Bob, rides the bus too. Bob walks Pete to his classroom.
Are you nervous?
Bob asks.
No,
says Pete.
I'm cool. See you after school.
Pete meets his teacher. She wears glasses and has lots of style. Welcome to preschool, she says with a big smile. At story time, Pete's teacher reads a book about a mouse who loves cookies and a cat who loves his shoes. Pete loves cookies and his shoes too. Next, it is time to paint. Pete paints a blue kitty as happy as could be.
Look, it's me! It's almost snack time! Let's wash our paws!
Pete eats his banana. He eats every bite.
Yum! That was just right!
Now it's time to sing! Everyone gathers around to sing their favorite songs. Pete loves singing along. Soon, it is time to go home, but Pete isn't ready to leave. He loves reading, painting, snacking, and getting to sing. Preschool is awesome! Pete loves everything! Did Pete have a great first day of school?
Yeah!
Absolutely!
Pete had so much fun, he didn't want to leave. Let's roll into the next story. Pete is excited to drive the school bus to school. Sing along as we read Pete the Cat, Wheels on the Bus by James Dean.
On the bus go swish 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 all day long.
The back of the bus bumps up and down, up and down, up and down. The back of the bus goes up and down all day long. The kitties on the bus go Pete the cat, Pete the cat, Pete the cat. The kitties on the bus go Pete the cat all day long. The dog on the bus goes woof, 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 woof. The dog on the bus goes woof, woof, woof all day long. The cats on the bus shout, let's rock out, let's rock out, let's rock out. The cats on the bus shout, let's rock out.
Isn't it great to just hang out with friends and sing songs?
Yeah!
In the next story, Pete and his friends build a treehouse. I can't wait to see the inside as we read Pete the Cat and the Tip Top Treehouse by James Dean. Pete the Cat has built a treehouse. He calls his friends.
I just built a treehouse,
he says.
Come over to play.
Pete's friends show up.
This is great,
say his friends.
But it is a little small.
You're right,
says Pete.
It is too small. I will fix that.
Pete starts building a bigger treehouse.
Do you want some help?
Asks Callie.
Sure,
says Pete. Callie carries up more wood.
Can I help too?
Asks Marty.
Sure,
says Pete. Together they build a tower for Pete's treehouse.
Let's have a treehouse party,
says Marty.
A party?
Says Pete.
But what will everyone do?
I can help with that,
says Emma.
This is great,
says Pete.
Let's do it.
Pete, Marty, Callie, Emma, and Grumpy Toad get right to work. They build an arcade. They fill it with fun games. They build a bowling alley. It has 20 lanes. They build a wave pool. Pete can surf indoors. They build a movie theater, and a skate park, and a climbing wall, and an ice rink. Pete's friends all come for the party. Pete takes one friend to the bowling alley. He takes one friend to the movie theater. Pete takes one friend to the skate park. Pete lets one friend surf in the wave pool.
Is everyone here?
Asks Pete.
Yeah, but we're all alone,
his friends say.
We came to play with each other.
Oh,
says Pete.
Everyone meet down at the jungle gym.
Everyone climbs down.
This treehouse is amazing,
say his friends.
Thanks, says Pete. I'm so glad it brought us all together.
How about that? Pete the Cat and his friends built an amazing treehouse, but in the end, they realized the value in spending time all together. In the next story, Pete is having a pizza party and everyone wants to add a different topping. How will the pizza turn out? Let's find out as we read Pete the Cat and the Perfect Pizza Party by Kimberly and James Dean. Pete the Cat loves pizza. Pete the Cat loves parties too. Pete had an idea of what he could do. He would have the perfect pizza party. Pete's friends all arrived. It was time to build the perfect pizza together. That would make the pizza even better. Pete thought the perfect pizza would be pepperoni with extra cheese.
It's a party, a party, a pepperoni pizza party.
But everyone did not agree. Callie said,
pepperoni would be just fine, but I really love pretzels on mine.
Pete and the gang were puzzled.
Pretzels?
Well, that's something new. But maybe pretzels could be groovy too.
It's a party, a pepperoni pretzel pizza party.
Squirrel said,
pepperoni and pretzels would be just fine, but I really love pistachios on mine.
Pete and the gang were puzzled.
Pistachios?
Well, that's something new, but maybe pistachios could be groovy too.
It's a party, a pepperoni pretzel pistachio pizza party.
Grumpy Toad said,
pepperoni, pretzels, and pistachios would be just fine. But I really love pickles on mine.
Pete and the gang were puzzled.
Pickles?
Well, that's something new. But maybe pickles could be groovy too.
It's a party, a pepperoni, pretzel, pistachio, pickle pizza party.
Gus said,
pepperoni, pretzels, pistachios, and pickles would be just fine, but I really love popcorn on mine.
Pete and the gang were puzzled.
Popcorn?
Well, that's something new. But maybe popcorn could be groovy too.
It's a party, a pepperoni, pretzel, pistachio, pickle, popcorn, pizza party.
Alligator said,
pepperoni, pretzels, pistachios, pickles, and popcorn would be just fine. But I really love papaya on mine.
Now Pete and the gang were really puzzled.
Papaya?
Well, that's something new. But maybe papaya could be groovy too.
It's a party, a party.
Pete and the gang piled the pepperoni, pretzels, pistachios, pickles, popcorn, and papaya on top. The pizza was so high, they had to stop. The pizza was done. Trying something new might be fun. They all built up the courage to take a first bite. And the pepperoni, pretzel, pistachio, pickle, popcorn, papaya pizza was out of sight! Dynamite, just right! In the end, the perfect pizza is a pizza shared with friends. Did you like that story?
Yeah!
So did I. There were so many toppings on the pizza, but in the end, everyone tried something new and loved it. In our final story, Pete is having a slumber party with his friends. Let's find out how it goes as we read Pete the Cat and the Bedtime Blues by Kimberly and James Dean. Pete and the gang had a great day. Surf and sun and tons of fun. But when the sun went down, they didn't want the fun to end. Pete had an idea.
Hey, how about a sleepover? More time for tons of fun.
Groovy!
Pete's place. Let's go!
The party was far out, but they knew they couldn't stay up all night. The gang decided it was time to say goodnight. On went the pajamas and out went the light.
Good night, Gus. Good night, Alligator. Good night, Toad.
Good night, Pete.
Pete was just about to catch some Z's when...
Clap, clap, clap. Who did that? Pete asked.
It was me, said Grumpy Toad. I don't want to go to bed. I want to clap instead.
Pete covered his head.
This cool cat needs to go to bed. Good night, Gus. Good night, Alligator. Good night, Toad.
Good night, Pete.
Time to sleep. Pete tried to catch some Z's when...
Rat-a-tat-tat! Who did that? Pete asked.
It was me, said Gus the platypus. I don't want to go to bed. I want to jam instead.
Pete covered his head.
This cool cat needs to go to bed.
Time to sleep.
Good night, Gus. Good night, Alligator. Good night, Toad.
Good night, Pete.
Pete closed his eyes to catch some Z's when he heard...
Munch, munch, munch.
Pete had a hunch. It was Alligator. He was always up for eating. What could Pete do? All the clapping, rat-a-tat-tatting, and munching was giving him the bedtime blues. Pete had a groovy idea. He got out his favorite bedtime story and started to read, first to himself and then to the gang. Pete noticed it was finally quiet. No more clapping, no more rat-a-tat-tatting, and no more munching. They all settled down. No one made a sound. Pete yawned and turned off the light.
Good night. Sleep tight.
Time to catch some Z's. Tomorrow was another day for surfing, sun, and tons of fun. Do you enjoy listening to stories before bedtime?
Yeah!
So do I! Pete's story helped everyone relax so they could fall asleep. Thank you all for joining us on these amazing reading adventures. It's Sweet Pea's bedtime. Good night, Sweet Pea, and good night to all of you.
Sweet Pea!
Please like and subscribe.